in the afternoon. As Evans in from the Rotterdam the Hague end, drops in, and that's going to race away, I believe, for the second boundary of the day. O'Dowd quick on the short ball and punished past Marquardt there at square leg, and that'll be four more, 14 without loss.
Yeah, it wasn't really gas. Attempt something.
Yeah, what a lovely shot from Myberg. Overpitched by Sharif, and that's going to run into the boundary boards and away for four runs. Lovely shot there, Shane.
Yeah, downhill, down breeze. This is the end you probably want to target, I would say, so you can actually dominate. That's a beautiful classic cover drive. And actually, the outfield, it looks lush. That's raced away to the four, up the hill, but he's timed it well. And that's a good shot.
And it's Evans running in towards us. And again, nailing that hard.
Bowlers loosening up. It'll be interesting to see the first and second change bowlers and how these two will attack them.
And the bowler punched. Wow. It's going to race. It looks a little bit slower on the pavilion side of the ground, but that was only chipped as they look to push for three. And O'Dowd's going to have to scamper, but makes it easily home in the end. That'll be three more runs for the total.
Definitely looking for some width here to swing through the offside. He hasn't got that again. Nice and tight on middle.
Clude is over from the VOC pavilion end into Myberg, who's caught. And that'll be caught at mid-off. Good little build-up there by Sharif, and he's got the plaudits for it.
Yeah, a few dots in a row, really cramping him up, and yeah, obviously he's did. Mid-off is up. That could be the go-to zone. He's just tried, come down the deck. I think he was looking for mid-off there, as that definitely did slice to deep backward point region. They come through for
42. As I get a message from an old friend in Scotland telling me that the commentary is excellent, Shane, so that's good. As O'Dowd sweeps from a mislined delivery from Watt, and Cooper's going to push back for three, and it's a good piece of fielding there from Hamza Tahir.
Sneak around the corner for a three. Is he coming again? Again fired in. He's outside off stump. He's got the outside edge, and Cooper has gone. He just didn't quite look at ease at the crease there today, Cooper, unfortunately. And he's looking for a bit of whip.
Persists with him as we see him come into Saylor once more. There's a planes overhead, that looks, and that's straight, and yeah, that's given. Saylor falling across a little and trying to shovel that ball into the leg side, and that's out, and it's 48 for three now in the 11th over. And to be fair,
cricket for sure. Oh, he's nicked it straight to first slip. Looked like that did a bit away from him as he looked to tuck it to the leg side, but like I say, it looks like he's doing a bit off the seam, and unfortunately he's nicked it, but well done by the skipper. Brought the two slips in, and it was always
only 50 out on the board, and looks like we're having a drinks break here at Hazel. 300 is definitely no shortage of a par as first slips in for, and that is bowled
through the gates. Looked like he played for a bit of spin and just went straight through the gate and hit the top of off. So,
and then delayed up 5 for 59. As we see, he is not best pleased with his own work. It's a fair effort to get half a team's worth, as Barrington will continue, and O'Dowd drives with a slightly open face to them around them, and only played them on Saturday, so should have them pretty fresh in my mind. As Zulfi can now strike it. It's very well pushed, and O'Dowd's going to have to scamper, and has very good wicket keeping coming round as the for the backing up. But we won't know. But McLeod with his hands and his head might feel like if he'd hit, that was out.
Flutter in there.
Yep, just attacking those stumps, and so we see that's going to be out. Yeah, as goes to the sweep, and oh, he looks completely jaded. Gavin Main, that's pitched up, and there's a scampered single. And
tough ask for the Scots to chase, especially if they get early wickets. He's in the ball, O'Dowd is smashed it through the offside. It's gone over backward point. Definitely get one, looking for two. It's gone for four, and that really broke the shackles. They needed that boundary. The other cover's gone back on the circle. It's a bit more defensive position. Might look to go to the sweep again here. No, he's gone downtown, over cover, short, and there's four, one bounce, just wide of long off. He showed his intent, didn't he?
Absolutely, that's the...
for him.
So, deep backward square, mid wicket, long on, long off, and cover on the boundary with Van Beek advancing, and that's straight as a die, and that will run away for four.
There it
is. Very good use of the feet, and a full flourish.
Changed it up with a little sweep here, put the bowler off his game. No, downtown again. Well, he's got the full toss, and he's gone well over long on, and that's a big sixer. And that show of intent, the ball before, the bowler tried to compensate.
Over.
I think take the pace off the ball is going to be the order of the day here. And he has done that, but he's got it full, and he's hit it to deep square leg, and the catch is taken. Yeah, he got the full toss. It was the slow ball, but he's just mistimed it, and he's picked out the fielder. Deep backwards spoils to be working towards.
Couldn't agree more, as we see a slight change on the field, and slow ball, and O'Dowd has absolutely demolished it. That has gone many a mile, and that's another one that's gone into the canal. And I think
two-leg stump.
Safian Sharif, a very canny operator for the Scots, one of their betters, as O'Dowd misses out again.
Yeah, hit it over the deep square leg side fielders. He's in the bowl again. He's got the short boys. Hit it into the gap.
That will race that away will race. For four.
Yes, that's the risk you take. If he gets it in that gap and couple of sixes here, getting a 90s would be a great finish for him. He's got a full, beautiful Yorker on leg stump.
And he's got to come back.
He's got to come back. He's got to come back. No, he's got to come back. That's young fella, just you to really forgive him for that. He needs to finish the job here for his team though, and get one over the rope. He's got a little inside edge down the deep square. They've got one. They're not coming back for two this time. And that's the end of the innings. 162, which
could be 164.
164
could be the pardon. Score after that. So we're going to leave you here. We will come back a couple of minutes before the start to give you a little bit of 64. There's slightly